There are over 7,000 languages spoken in the world today. Think about a language that you don't know. Think about how it sounds. You might recognize some of those sounds from your own language, like the vowel sound ah or the consonant sound s. But what might be tricky is grouping these sounds together into the words that they belong to. This is in part because, despite what you might think, in natural speech, there are no clear pauses between words. In fact, there is no reliable sound cues that tell you how to group sounds into words at all. But when you're listening to a language that you can understand, this fact poses no problem for you. Those vowel and consonant sounds magically assemble, shoop, into words that now carry meaning. So how is it that you're able to so easily group sounds into words in languages that you know? What changes when speech means something to you versus when it doesn't? I study these questions by looking at the human brain. Our lab has the unique opportunity to work with patients whose brains are being monitored by very small electrical sensors that a neurosurgeon places underneath their skull directly onto their brain surface. These patients, who have many different language backgrounds, graciously volunteer to help out with my research by listening to speech in their native language and a language that they don't know. While they do this, my lab mates and I observe the neural activity going on in their brains. And excitingly, I found that you can tell when someone's listening to their native language by looking at their brain activity. How? Well, you look at moments when one word ends and another begins, also known as a word boundary. When you listen to speech you can understand, word boundaries are effortlessly identified. You're doing it right now as you listen to me speak. And as it turns out, when I used machine learning models to analyze the signals of the brain, I found that your brain is helping you to do this by tracking where word boundaries are in speech, but only when you understand the language that you're listening to. So we concluded that one ingredient to language understanding is our brains figuring out when words end and begin. This is a major step in demystifying the magic that allows us to understand spoken language. And it's also an important reminder that when we encounter something that our brain does that feels magical, we can pull back the curtain to reveal the complicated and fascinating work being done behind the scenes to make it all happen. Thank you.
The first place winner, who will also represent UCSF at the Systemwide Grad Slam, and who will earn, in a moment, $4,000? Drum roll, please, and Brian.
All right, and the award goes to Ilina Bhaya-Grossman.
Now, you guys can feel free to come down and take pictures with your labs, with your people. All of you did a fantastic job. Thank you for entertaining us and educating us today. I just want to call out one special person. This dude spends his whole life for about 3 months organizing the event, working with the students, working on the trivia questions. The man knows history like you wouldn't believe. So please join me in thanking Eric Rothman. He is somewhere around here. Come here, Eric. Come here, Eric. There you go.